Now, in the sequencer class, we actually are not doing anything new. We will keep it as it is. This class will take sequences one by one and provide it to the driver to drive. Just one thing we need to note is that we need to parameterize this class. What parameterization means is that we are telling the class which type of packet are we going to use in this class. So for that, the syntax is something like this. We need to write hashtag and then name of our sequence item class. So we will write hashtag and the name is our packet. So we will tell it that we are going to use our packet to generate the stimulus. Rest everything remains the same, and there is not much of a logic in this sequencer class. Let's move on to the driver. Similar to the sequencer class, we also need to parameterize the driver class and let it know which type of packet are we going to use. So we write same as in sequencer class, we have to write the name of our packet class, which is our packet. Now in this driver class, we also need to instantiate our packet class and create an object using type ID create method. So let's do that. We will write our packet and pkt. This is, we instantiated the packet, and now we can create object using type ID create method. And since this is a component class, we will utilize the build phase for that, which is quite efficient. So we write pkt is equal to our packet type ID create, and we write our packet. In the run phase, we will utilize the forever begin loop. So our main logic in the driver will lie in between forever begin loop. So we write forever begin and we need to write some kind of logic in here. So we want our logic to run on passage of clock, just like how we do in always begin block, right? So for that, we write at passage of clock. So this is very similar to always block. Now to drive the packet, we need to get the packet first from the sequencer. So for that, we write that sequence item port dot get next item of type packet. So what we are saying is from sequence item port get next item, which means it will get the packet from sequencer. Now we need to drive that packet onto the interface. So what we will do is we'll assign the variables on the interface. So for doing that, we need to write interface dot input underscore one, which is one variable, and we will use non-blocking assignment to it. So we will assign packet dot input one. So what we will do is we are assigning input one value from the packet to the variable on the interface. Similarly, let's do it for another variable too. For that we write interface dot input to same non-blocking assignment packet dot input to. We are assigning the variable input to's value to the interface. So we assigned all the variables to the interface. Now we need to tell the port that we are done. So for that we need to write sequence item port dot item done. This will tell the sequencer that driver has driven one packet and it is ready to accept next package, and this will go on until forever or the clock expires. Now one thing to note is the clock that we are using is coming from interface, so we cannot directly write clock. We need to write in hierarchical form. So we will write intf interface dot clock because we are using interface clock. So this is our driver class. Let's move on to the monitor class now. Just like other classes, we need to instantiate packet class and create an object for it using type id create method. So to instantiate the class, we will write our packet pkt, and then in the build phase we will write packet is equal to our packet type id create. We can write our packet. In the run phase, we need to get the packet that the driver sent to the interface. So in the main logic, what we will write is first we need a forever block. So we write forever begin end, and we only need to get the packet at passage of clock. So intf dot clock. In the forever loop, we will assign the signals from the interface to our packet in monitor. For that, we will use non-blocking assignment. So we write packet dot input one interface dot input one and packet dot input two interface dot input two. That's it. This is how we write basic monitor class. Simple, right? Let's see the agent class now. In the agent class, we already instantiated the subcomponents, so we do not need to do anything else for now. In the interface, we need to define the variables that we are going to use. So first of all, let's write the variables that we are going to use and assign logic as the data type. So we write logic input 1. Logic input 2, logic output 3. Let's verify the variables. We can give different names to these, but just for the sake of simplicity, I'm giving them the same names. So yeah, input 1, input 2, output 3. Let's define the size also, 7 down to 0. Okay, now the interface will also have clock coming from the top module. So we need to define it as an input. So we write input logic clock. we could have written logic clock here, but since this clock is coming from the top module, we need to declare it as an input, and that we can do in the interface definition like this. So we should not write logic clock here. So all the signals which are coming from outside, like from the top module, we need to define them as input or output. So this is the interface class. Now the environment class will also remain the same for now. Later we will add scoreboard here. Currently we have created the agent class inside the environment class.